Power clean versus hand clean difference. What is the difference between power cleans and hand cleans? In this tutorial, we talk about the differences between a power clean and a hand clean. What are commonalities in the power clean and the hand clean? The differences of the power clean technique and the hand clean technique, and the implications of these technique differences. Very often you hear the question, what is the difference between a hand clean and a power clean? Well, let's first start with the commonalities, and then it's also easier to understand what the differences are. What are the commonalities in a power clean and a hand clean? Well, both lifts, the hand clean as well as the power clean, are a training exercise used in Olympic weightlifting to improve the performance lift of the clean or clean and jerk. So in weightlifting, one of the competition lifts, there are two competition lifts Olympic weightlifters are evaluated on. One is the snatch, where you bring a weight from the ground over your head and you stand up. And one is the clean and jerk, where you bring the weight from the ground onto your shoulders, stand up, and from your shoulders you bring it over your head. And the clean is one part of this competition lift, clean and jerk. And the hand clean, as well as the power clean, are a training exercise originated from Olympic weightlifting to improve that competition part, that competition lift of the clean. And then at a later stage, these lifts have made their entrance into sports performance training. And most of the times in sports performance training, coaches looked at variations of the clean, for example, that are a bit easier to perform than the clean. And then the hand clean, as well as the power clean, is such a training derivative, which is a bit easier to perform than the full clean. Back to the topic of power clean versus hand clean differences. What are these differences? Well, the first difference is obviously the execution of the exercise and the movement. A power clean is characterized by it starts on the ground, similar to a clean, but opposed to the clean, the catch position, so where you receive the bar on your shoulders in the dip or quarter squat, is less deep than in a clean. So in a clean, you receive the bar at full depth. In a power clean, you receive it a bit higher. So this is the differences between a clean and a power clean. What does that have to do with the differences of power clean and hand clean? Well, let's get to what a hand clean is. A hand clean is basically where you start from the hang, so that means the bar is somewhere hanging in the air, and you perform a clean, which means you catch it in a deep position. Whilst the hang position can vary, I've done a previous video on what is a hang power clean, so hang power clean and hang clean is not the same thing. What is a hang power clean? And I explained that there are different positions where you can start your hang. From the hip, from mid-thigh, from above the knee, from below the knee, and from mid-chin. So quick wrap-up. Power clean starts from the ground, catches the bar above parallel. Hang clean starts from the hang and catches the bar in a full deep squat position. Power clean versus hang clean technique. Let's have a look at the differences in the power clean technique versus the hang clean technique. Again, I would refer back to the clean technique as a framework for the technique of the power clean and the hang clean. And the clean technique generally goes through different phases. So you have the start position when the weight is on the ground, the first pull from the ground until below your knees, the transition from below the knees to above the knees or mid-thigh, the second pull where you maximally accelerate the weight from mid-thigh position where the bar makes contact with your thighs, the catch where you receive the bar, and the recovery where you stand back up into the end position. Whilst different weightlifting federations have slightly different technique models, this is one of the general accepted models, but again, they change a little bit. Generally, different phases of the clean technique. So how's the power clean technique different to the clean technique? Not very much. The power clean goes through all phases of the clean technique, only with a modification, obviously, in the catch position and the recovery position. Because, that's what I've outlined before, you catch it less deep or you catch it in a higher position. So the catch phase is different than in a clean, where you catch it in a deeper position, which then also has an effect on the recovery. So whether you get up from a half squat, quarter squat in the power clean or whether you have to get up from a full squat in the clean. Let's have a look at the hang clean technique. Generally speaking, depending on the start position, the hang clean leaves out the first pull. So instead of pulling it from the ground until below the knee, the hang clean doesn't have that phase, only if you're starting from a mid-shin position. That is the only exception to the rule. However, the catch phase and the recovery phase are identical in the hang clean technique and in the clean technique, because you catch it deeper, so that's why you have to catch it, and you have to recover from that position. So quick wrap up here as well. What are the differences in the technique, power clean versus hang clean? Not many differences. The power clean goes through the same phases with a modification in the catch and the recovery due to the higher position when you catch. And the hang clean, generally speaking, doesn't have the first pull, maybe also not the transition, but identical in the second pull, catch and recovery phase. Okay, how is that important to know? What are the implications of the differences in the power clean technique and the hang clean technique? Well, again, we need to look at who is our target audience, who are our trainees. So in Olympic weightlifting, these exercises and these techniques have a very specific purpose, as I've outlined, because they want to improve the clean, which is part of the competition lift. When we're training for sports performance, it's a bit different because we're using different lifts for different purposes. So we want to increase any capacity which could lead to the athlete being faster, more explosive, whatsoever. Slight differences here, yeah? So are we talking about Olympic weightlifting or training for sports performance? Back to the topic. What are the differences in the power clean technique versus the hang clean technique? In very general and simple words, and please, this is not a definite answer, this is just an outline. The hang clean essentially focuses very much on a quick turnaround from the second pull to the catch. So when you accelerate the weight up and get under it, so that switch from extension to getting under the bar, this is what the hang clean really focuses on. Why is that? Because usually the external load is quite high, so you won't be able to get it very high, maybe on height of your belly button, and from there you have to quickly get under it in order to still have enough time to decelerate and control the bar and then recover. The power clean on the other side allows to accelerate the bar over a longer distance. Plus, in order to catch it high, you also need to pull it a bit higher. Well, that's logical, right? So you probably need to catch it a bit, you need to pull it a bit higher, so on height of your sternum, more or less. So again, in very simple words and not as a definite answer, you could say the power clean works more on pulling strength, whilst the hang clean works more on a quick turnaround and catch of the entire movement. So to wrap up the power clean versus hang clean difference. What is the difference between hang cleans and power cleans? Both exercises originate from Olympic weightlifting and are meant to improve the competitive lift of the clean and jerk, especially the clean portion of that lift. The movement is slightly different. The power clean starts from the ground and catches it in a higher position. The hang clean starts from the hang, and I've outlined there are different possibilities where you can start your hang. So the hang clean starts from the hang and catches it in a deeper position. The power clean technique is very similar to the clean technique, only with modifications in the catch and recovery position. And the hang clean generally leaves out the first pull and the transition maybe of the clean technique, but the catch and recovery position phases are essentially the same. And the implications of those differences in the technique on the movement. The power clean works more on the pulling strength because it allows to accelerate the weight over a longer distance. And the hang clean focuses on a quick turnaround, catch and recovery of the lift. So what's your opinion? Did you know these differences before I have outlined them in this video? Do you still have any questions? Please leave it in the comments below, and I will answer them to the best of my ability.